All right, everyone come to attention, back straight, and a good bow, sign of respect. Awesome. We're gonna get moving around, we're gonna get doing our jumping jacks and get our body warmed up. So the first thing to do is jumping jacks, get your body moving. And I'm actually gonna come up and fix one thing in my camera real quick here. And then I can get started. Boom. There we go. All right, now I'm back to rock and roll. Let's go some side to side jumping jacks, change it up just a little bit. So you're hopping side to side, getting that body nice and loose, get that coordination down. Jumping jacks. All right, forward and back. All right, jog it in place. Working, getting those knees up. Try to bring those knees up to at least belly height. Get that heart rate up a little bit. Get that blood flowing. Get those joints nice and loose. All right, top and low. Get it lower with your feet. Lower, 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 then start to speed it up. Jump, 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 jump. Make it sound like there's like a hurricane at the house or something. Okay, stop. Shake your legs out. Body squats, let's go. Let's get those legs away. So you're dropping up and down. Mr. Anderson, we're already teaching workout classes, so I'm pretty sure we already have our legs worked out. And we're doing it, so that means you can do it. Up and down. Come on, give me 10 more seconds. Want that heart rate up a little bit. Want that body warm. When your body's worn out, your ears are ready to listen, your mind's ready to capture. All right, have a seat. Let's get a quick stretch in those legs. One leg out, one leg in. Back straight. Arch your back, chin up, rotate your hips forward. All right. So we're starting to push yourself down into that stretch. We're starting to think about our expectations for our jiu-jitsu training. It's one of the things we've been doing this month. Let's switch our legs, other foot, is we're kind of trying to figure out in the next 12 months of jiu-jitsu training, what is our expectation for ourselves that we're going to accomplish and what's going to come true. Last week we talked about, for this expectation, what are some of the goals we should set? What are some of the activities or actions we need to take to make sure that everything comes true, right? Because just expecting it to happen and not really paying attention to the details won't really work. All right, straddle position, legs apart. So once we start to figure out what are our goals, what are our actions, what has to happen for this to become reality, the next thing we're trying to figure out is what kind of obstacles will you run into? Will the COVID shut everything down? That'll be an obstacle. You can't get to class, right? Could you have an injury, right? Outside playing or something, you twist an ankle. Could your grade slip a little bit and you have to spend more time doing homework, right? Could you have to work more hours? So start to figure out what kind of obstacles can get in the way of your expectation happening. And then I want you to start setting up a plan for each one of those problems. Whatever kind of obstacle, keep going left and right, or problem you run into, you know, what's your plan? If COVID happens, you train with us online. It's my life. People are already doing that. If you have an injury, right, do you modify your workouts? Do you find workouts you can still do, training things you still can do? Let's go butterfly position. That allow you to still keep on track, right? At least some of the stuff is getting done then. You have to work more hours. So maybe now you're looking at changing up your class schedule. 2 days, maybe you're not usually here. So something to kind of think about. Let's figure out what the expectation is. Let's figure out how we have to make it come true, and then already plan ahead for what might happen, and then already have our plan in place, right? You don't just say, man, I hope there's never a tornado because we don't know what to do, right? You have a plan. There's a thing you do when there's a tornado. All right, so now we're gonna go on our back. We're gonna pull our knee across our body. So grab your knee, pull it up, bring it all the way across your body, reach your hand out, oh, stretch that back out. And the other way. Pull that knee across all the way to the floor. Oh yeah, stretch that back out. All right, we're gonna roll back, touch your toes behind your head. So roll back, touch your toes. Then come forward, and since we're back there, let's do snake meters. Rotate those feet, get them moving in a circle. Same direction, just keep them going. And then reverse, the other direction around the circle. Rotate those legs, keep them moving. All right, relax. I'm actually gonna adjust one of my cameras real fast. So you gotta give me just a second, I'll be right back. I just noticed that it is not level. That's not very fun, right? We wanna make sure that our camera is level. So the people watching it later don't have a weird skewed view. Okay, so what we're gonna work on today is how to break someone's ankle, right? Or get a submission through an ankle lock. So if Mr. Anderson is nice enough to just take his ankle and kick me in the armpit. Bang. Okay, so we're gonna get a hold of the ankle. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna have my foot on his ribs and my other knee in close. Okay, can you guys see how that looks? So this foot here is stepping right on his ribs, right on the side, not crossing over the top of his leg, it's right on the side. My other arm is underneath his leg, and this foot here, you can see where my foot is. You'll see sometimes videos where they tell you to put it here. Don't put your foot here. Right when I'm here, I actually want the other side of him. And I can explain more later why, okay? So now when I'm here, I'm going to bring my arms up, I'm gonna shrug my shoulders back, open my chest, and I'm gonna push on him, and I'm gonna get a tap. I'm not gonna have to fall all the way back to get it. And what we're doing is we're attacking the ankle. The ankle can really only go so far before it just dislocates, right? So we're looking at a dislocation of the ankle with this, so be careful. Never go too fast, never grab too tight, right? And partners, pay attention to where the top of your ankle hurts. Now, we're also, by chance, going to be putting our wrist bone into the Achilles tendon, which can also be very painful, right? And that would be a secondary action we're trying to do. It's not our primary. If that's what's happening, be ready to tap, and that's another way to get this submission too, okay? So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go through the steps of how to get to this motion, and we're actually gonna teach it from an open guard position. So we'll be standing, we'll be doing it from open guard, and then dropping into position, and then I'll get through the details of the grips and how to finish it in a little bit, okay? So we're gonna have one person stand, and one person down, and actually looking at my camera, I'm gonna adjust it one more time. Remember, we have multiple cameras, and I need to adjust just one more of them, because otherwise, my live people are gonna get a way different view from my other people. Okay, so he's got his feet up in my hips. I'm gonna grab onto his pant legs, right? So I grab his pant legs, and I'm gonna be trying to control his legs like this. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna push one down, and I'm gonna pull one up, right? So I have one down, one up, and I'm gonna step. I'm gonna go into the sweet spot position, which is my shin, right behind the back of his leg, and my foot close to his hip. So if it's on the other side, it's like this. I don't want to be here, because he can start to wrap his leg, and he can start to then move around, okay? What I want to be is here, where I'm pushing into him a little bit, right? So you can see this leg, I'm gonna go on this side. So I step in here. Now, this foot here is gonna step way up to the ribs, and I'm gonna hook his leg, and I'm gonna sit myself down. So I'm underneath one leg, and I'm around the outside of one, and the foot is in my armpit. This is all I need for right now. And he's a good guy, so he pulls his toes back to protect himself. I'll actually show you how to defeat that pretty fast, okay? And this is what I want you to get into. I don't need you to wrap the leg up right now. I don't need you to drop back and try and hurt it. We're just gonna step up. I go back, and I stand up again. Okay, I'll show you another angle, and then we'll start to get our reps. So, he has his feet on me. I'm controlling him, right? I'm gonna step my leg inside, so I'm behind his leg. I'm pulling up on the other one, and I'm stepping. This way it's coming over the outside of my hip. I don't want it on me, because he can push. Right, so I lift, and I get it here. Because now if I was gonna pass, and he starts to defeat me, or try, right, it's actually a very hard pass to get around. So I wanna have this up on my body here, I wrap around the leg, and I sit down. Okay, so this is the position I'm gonna be learning to get to. This foot here, when I do the submission, will stand on his ribs. Remember, no striking, it's not that kind of a sport. My other foot, excuse me, sir, this foot here is underneath the leg on that side. It's not crossed over, because if you've been watching since the YouTube, you'll see some people that go here, and I'll show you why I don't like that idea in a little bit, okay? So, get some reps with me, and then partners, get some reps with Mr. Anderson, and then if you're live, we're actually gonna pause. We're gonna come up and watch you, and then watch your repetitions again. Okay, and at that point, if you're not live, just get repeat back a second time. Okay, so ready? I'm gonna start out doing from a couple angles, make it a little bit easier to see. Mr. Anderson's got his feet on me, put a little pressure, pull his legs up. I step, I'm in the back of his thigh, I cinch down, and I drop into position, right? I'm on the outside, and I'm underneath for right now. All right, then we hop back up. Do it again. Remember, start getting your repetitions. Start going, let's go. Get moving. He's got his feet on me. Come on, let's go. I see people needing to get started. So we go here, I move in, I step, I lift, I drop down, and I've got that leg. Tucked underneath my armpit, right? Other foot's here, other one's here, it's ready to go on the ribs. And do one more time, then Mr. Anderson will go, and at that point, the partner should be going on his. So here, controlling, right like this. Step up, fall back. Getting a hold underneath the far side, tucking the leg. All right, so now Mr. Anderson's gonna go on his feet. He'll give you the second angle. Which leg are you going after, sir? Okay, great. So we're here, grabs the pant leg, steps back, has man, steps up behind the thigh in the sweet spot. This leg's up across his hip. Yep, tucks it into his armpit, has a seat. Yeah, good. Now, as you can see here, this foot would go on my ribs. He would have his heel leading and his toes turn. Yep, good. So that way, if I'm trying to move, he can push on me. So you're gonna get two more reps, and we're gonna watch our live people and see how it's going. So the feet are up on the hips, controlling. So it's back, sweet spot and lift. This way, this leg can't wrap because I want to wrap this foot and start to control, right? But by getting way up my leg, just put about where my belt is, makes it real hard to use that leg to do stuff. Hooks it, squeezes knees, fall back. Awesome, ready to go. To go one more time. Open guard position. Steps. Fall back. Good. Nice. All right, so again, if you're at home and you're watching, I want you to pause. Get your repetitions real quick. We'll be right back. All right, welcome back to the people who are not live with us. Here's how this works. We are now going to kind of talk about some of the points of this. We're going to start on the floor now that we showed you that so we can get through this a little bit different. So I'm going to have him just put his leg right into the fire pit. Okay, good. So this foot here is going to be on the outside, right? I'm not going to bring it up across his leg, so I'm not bringing it up across his leg. I'm just stepping on his ribs. It's like I'm trying to kick him in the ribs. The reason I want to do this is if he can pull himself up to me, right, he can start to try to scoot into position. He can even start to really climb into some submission kind of situations. Right here, I think. Yeah, he can try to climb up. So by having my foot on his ribs, if he tries to pull himself to me, I just use my leg. I just push him back, right? So my leg is holding him off. So that's one reason I want to have it here, right? If I'm here, his escape, if I fall to my side and my leg down, is to hop over the top of my leg and then to start to try to climb in. So if I have my foot up across his ribs, it stops that, right? And I'm upright. Now, if I was laying on my side, this would be a lot easier for him to push that foot down and clear it, okay? So what I wanna do is I wanna stay upright, keep my foot on his ribs. Now this arm here is gonna swoop underneath here, right? So you can see this, I'm not just gonna go on my wrist. If I cinch up on my wrist, I'm attacking his Achilles tendon. So what happens then is I'm chopping him right here and it hurts because I'm stretching it out and then I'm popping this tendon. That's pain, but it's not the one I'm looking for. I'm looking for more of the ankle pain. So I'm gonna wrap my arm all the way underneath. So when I do this, excuse me, sir, I'm gonna wrap my arm all the way underneath and try and get it all the way back to my chest like so, right? And I'm not gonna get it to my far side. I want his leg to be resting right in the middle of my forearm. So his leg will be right over my forearm. Now to make this easier on my body, since we already learned how to get to position and we already learned what position looks like, I'm just gonna go up on my knees. And this allows me to practice my grip and be a little more comfortable with my partner. So now he scoots in closer, he puts his foot up, and now this is a lot easier on my body to practice. So I'm taking my middle of my forearm, putting it around his leg, and I'm trying to lift his leg as high as I can, right? So I'm just taking, I'm scooping, and I'm lifting. So I'm bringing it up. So I'm not leaving it down low, I'm trying to bring it up nice and high. One of the things I don't want is I don't want him to roll his hip over and pull his heel out, either direction, right? So if he starts to roll his leg over, right, and he starts to get his heel out, now if he starts to roll the other way, yeah, look, boom, see that heel just popped out? That's not very good. I don't want his heel popping out of my grip. So I'm not gonna grab up here where he can rotate his body out and pull his heel out, very good. And I'm not gonna grab real shallow where he can rotate, that by the way, there you go, another one destroys his own knee. With the back end. So now I'm gonna get nice and high. And the next thing I'm gonna do is see my elbows out? I'm gonna tuck my elbow in. So I'm gonna clamp down. So instead of having my elbow out here, I clamp it down onto his leg. So I'm lifting high, my elbow clamps. So he rotates his heel and go anywhere. Not saying it's impossible, but it's a lot tighter. So I'm grabbing my hand, I'm pulling it to my chest, I'm lifting up and I'm clamping my elbow, okay? So let's work on this grip real fast. So I'll grab his leg, I'll get the position, right? Cinch it nice and high. I lift it higher, and I tuck my elbow and ask my partner to turn his knee out and rotate his foot out. If his foot pops out, I need to get tighter up on that leg, okay? If I ask him to rotate his foot out and it can't go anywhere, that means I have the grip right. That means I'm having pressure in the middle of my forearm, my elbow's tucked around his ankle, and I'm holding it high. If I hold down by my waist, he just pulls his foot out, right? And that's the direction he's gonna go to escape anyway. So I go here, I tuck, he rolls, nope. I'm trying to trap his heel. So his heel, when he tries to rotate, is pushing into my ribs, and his toes can't move because I'm clamping down, right? So I'm not grabbing a figure four lock either. I'm just grabbing my own hand and I'm lifting up. Okay, let's change angles, sir. So I'll show you another angle, then we'll start our repetition. So I just start on my knee, I cinch up high, I pull nice and tight, I grip my elbow, and then I ask him to rotate. Don't ask him to hurt himself. I let go and I do it again. So I'll do two more times. I get around, I lift up, I cinch my elbow back, I hold his leg. Trying to limit his ability to move. Yeah, so he doesn't feel comfortable there. All right, we'll have Mr. Anderson go a couple times and we'll check to see if our live people have this grip down. Looks like you got it. All right, there we go. So he gets the middle of his forearm right underneath my leg, grabs his own hand, lifts up super high, and then what happens, I want him to do it wrong the first time actually, so he doesn't tuck his elbow, keeps his elbow, and he can see how my foot can rotate and come out. Now he tucks his elbow in, and he kind of clamps his elbow back to like his wings on his back. Now, can you feel how that's gripped? Yeah, that's hard for me to get out of, right? I can't turn my ankle. All right, good, so he does a couple more grips. We'll go a couple more repetitions. Gets it nice and high, cinches up super high. Yeah, ouch, yes, that'll hurt. Okay, gets it up nice and high. All right, make sure we're getting repetitions. We're doing this right now so you can watch and watch repetitions. Yeah, he's got it nice and high, he's got it cinched. Oh man, right? And it doesn't feel good. Kind of like one of those would feel good. All right, nice. All right, so I want you to just take some time. Just grip it, have him turn, grip it, have him turn a couple repetitions. So at this point, pause. When you feel like you have it down, you're not making the mistake, you're not getting the heel up, then come back and we'll do it live, okay? All right, welcome back. I hope you have it. I saw something live. If I have time today, I'll actually touch on a whole nother variation, which is pretty cool. I don't plan on doing it, but if I have time, I'll show it to you. It's kind of fun. Just something I saw in the live people. So let's figure out how to get this thing to hurt. That being said, be very careful. When you're pulling on a leg, you have some people who are just kind of hyperflexible, they don't really feel a lot of pain, then all of a sudden, just poof. So whenever we're doing any kind of knee, ankle, any of that kind of stuff, just be careful with your partner. Try not to ever move too fast. Partners, pay attention to your body. If you feel like, you know, there's a good amount of pressure building, probably start tapping at this point, especially anything that where it's not a live class where instructor can actually stop and say, hey, that's too far of a motion for your joint, okay? All right, so Mr. Anderson's gonna put his foot up my armpit. He's a nice guy. I'm gonna get underneath. Now watch, see how this foot's way back here? This doesn't do me any good, right? And he's gonna pull his toes back. So I wanna be up. And what I'm trying to do is put my arm right here, right underneath his ankle, nice and high. So I'm gonna get right on his ankle. I'm not gonna get up on his calf. So I'm here, I'm in the middle. I'm lifting it up nice and high. And now I'm gonna take my shoulders and I'm gonna go like this. So kind of like this, right? Shrug your shoulders. So if you watch how I do this, I shrug my shoulders. I go like this and rolling my shoulders, right? Kind of like you're dancing, right? Okay, so you're rolling your shoulders. So when I get his ankle in there, I get up nice and high. I cinch it up. I trap my elbow and I roll. And when I open up my chest, you see him jump, right? So I don't want to go real fast. I'm not a fast dancer, right? It's a little, real slow beat, kind of like grandma's feet. And I shrug, and I open, I'm looking up, I'm pushing my chest to the ceiling. Can you feel that, sir? Isn't that fun? So I go here, I tuck my elbows, I'm squeezing my elbows, and I roll my shoulders. I'm gonna do a couple more, though, Mr. Anderson, break my ankle, and then we're gonna watch our live people. So I'm going here, and you watch my shoulders, I'm leaning back like this. I don't want to keep leaning back too far. I just squeeze real tight. And it's a small motion. You really shouldn't see me move very much. Right? You should be like, he's there, and then all of a sudden, he's tapping. It's kind of fun. All right. I let him bust my ankle a little bit. And then we're going to watch our live people. So if you already got it, start working. Right? So he's got it nice and high. He's pulling up. He traps it with his elbow, so I can't turn my foot, and it's deep enough where I can't turn it. And then he starts to shrug. So he opens up his shoulders, and he pops. And you're just going to pull your elbows behind you and just kind of puff your chest up. Yeah. Up. Pop. Yeah, the top of my ankle just is not going to be my friend. And all these, tap early because you don't be walking funny the next day, right? So he's going here. Yeah, one more time, sir. Yeah, good. I'm smart, man. I'm going to tap as soon as I feel it. I might sometimes hold out a little bit just to make sure my partner's going to hurt it, but I always tap early. If I tap early, I get to tap tomorrow. If I don't tap early, I don't get to play tomorrow. So
Essentially, you're grabbing it and holding it real high. And just get a lot of reps on this one. Just rep it a lot before you move on, okay? Because if you don't have this down, everything's just harder. But I lift my shoulders up, and I roll them back. So making a rolling motion like this, right? So you're rolling. You could even kind of become a better dancer through jiu-jitsu. So I get up real tight, my elbows clamp, and I roll and I puff my chest. Cool? Okay, let's get that straight ankle lock. We're gonna watch our live people. All right, if we understand how to do the shoulder rolling and the tightness on the ankle, then we're gonna be doing just fine. Like I said earlier, I'm gonna still explain why we don't wanna cross our foot underneath the leg. I didn't forget, I will explain why I don't want you to do that. And then other parts is when we're rolling the shoulders, it's just a better deal. And I'll kind of go over a few things now from the position. So I'm gonna have Mr. Anderson here, and I'm gonna have him actually grab onto my leg and put in his armpit. He puts his other foot on the outside of my ribs, and he steps his foot to the wrong spot. I'll move this leg so you can see. So he tucks it underneath my seat, which is actually one of the ways I learned how to do this, right? But here's the reason. Now this, if you're strictly gonna follow the rules, this isn't really a problem. But what judges don't see aren't illegal, right? So that with that mentality of cheaters out there, but if you're gonna do the IBJJF, I do believe that the heel hooks are illegal in all gi competition. So if he starts to get this submission, right? And go ahead and get the submission. And I grab his ankle like this and I pull, that's his knee, right? If I pull this heel up, it breaks his knee, which is illegal, like I said, in gi jiu-jitsu tournaments. But it doesn't mean I can't do it, right? Just because it's illegal doesn't mean I won't do it to him. So the risk of this, or just when you're free rolling with someone who knows about ankle locks, right, and heel hooks, they might do this to you. And I don't like that's available. So if I have Mr. Anderson's foot in my armpit here, and I have this foot tucked here, and I'm here, and I start to get the submission, and he grabs that heel, he can twist, and there goes my knee, right? Now I got to tap. Where if I put this foot over here, right, and I'm like this, now if he tries to grab my heel, it's much harder, right? He can't get my heel over there and do what it is he's trying to do. So now I've got this, okay? Now, one more cool thing about being on this side here is if he falls to the side with me and he hops over this foot, right? Look, what do? Yeah, I just go to the other side. I have the leg hook, I've got the ribs, and now I start to go after the other ankle. If he turns and hops over my leg, I just switch to catch and I come back to the opposite side. So one of the benefits of being over here compared to here is that I can very easily catch this leg. If he starts to try to hop over, I can just catch this one, transfer and go to my opposite side for my straight ankle lock. So it's kind of a nice little system to have. So it's one of the reasons why we want to be over there. The other reason is illegal submissions can happen and that can hurt your knee, and then you're walking funny. So let's get back in position. I'm going to do the ankle lock a couple different times from different angles, and then I'll let Mr. Anderson break me up, and then we'll watch our live people. So I'm stepping on the ribs, right? I'm underneath the far leg. I have my arm wrapped underneath. I'm pulling up super high. I'm tucking my elbows. So see this? I tuck my elbows. So if he tries to turn his foot, not happening. I'm holding him back so he doesn't come up on top of me. And then I just shrug my shoulders. And I look up. I'm trying to push my chest in, kind of like the Care Bear stare. I think their belly button used to shoot rays out or something. This is my Care Bear ankle lock. Ah, twist and pop. Squeeze my elbow. Look up. And like I said, he might pull his toes back, right? I don't get deep enough. And now, I might be able to drill into his Achilles tendon in the back of his leg. I'm doing a nice mean thing to his leg. But I can't get the ankle. So watch, if I go here, and I just wiggle back and forth, I have it again. Cool? So let's first focus on good position, getting the tap, right, from the normal grip. I'll come back and I'll revisit what to do if they pull their toes back. I'll show you one, a great way to defend if your partner doesn't know this, and then two, a great way to stop it, which actually isn't very hard. Cool? I'm gonna do one more submission from this angle, then I'm gonna hand it back to Mr. Anderson. So I'm gonna go at this angle so you can see, right? I got the foot in my armpit, I'm stepping on the ribs, I'm coming underneath the leg, I'm here, watch my elbows squeeze my back, I'm protecting this leg here, and I think of going, oh yes, I'm looking up and I'm arching. All right, let's get back to Mr. Anderson. Which angle do you wanna go, sir?
First.
All right, so he grabs a hold of my ankle, I'm gonna drop back so you guys can see just fine. He gets a hold of it, right? He's stepping on my rib, and I'm just gonna lay back just because I want you to see. He gets underneath this leg here, so if I try to grab his heel and do something to it, it's not as easy for me to do anything to that leg. He's got a nice high cinches, right? I mean, right now, I'm being a jerk trying to pull my toes back. And now, what he's gonna do is he's gonna pull his elbows behind and shrug his shoulders. and gets that, oh, that straight ankle lock. It's nasty, right? And again, he's just shrugging backwards. Oh, that hurts. Right now, if I started to try to pull myself up, he would then push to help extend, right? And then he shrugs his shoulders. Yeah. So he can use this stepping motion. Let's change angles for him, sir. Which way are you going? Okay. So then he can use that foot to extend his own body away and stop me from coming up. So he's on my ribs, right? And he's stepping. He's got it cinched up. He's dropping back. Oh, it's already tight. Man, that was already the right position. That elbow, when he tucks that elbow, that gets it. Making it much harder. And you see he's staying upright. And the reason we're focused on that is, remember, if we turn to the side, we can hop over. If you take this leg apart, sir. Right, so he gets this one, right? Because what I want is when he starts to get in this position for this mission, I want to sit up. I want to grab a hold of him. Because I don't want him, if he starts to shrug his shoulders, I don't want him to be able to arch back. And I want this one on the floor so I can hop it and start to climb in, right? Yeah. Well, he started blocking, but if he doesn't block, what I'm looking for, yeah, look at that flexibility, is this right here. I'm going to hop right into a leg triangle position because sometimes people don't necessarily put the hand up. And once you clear that, if you're nice and flexible and fast, you can hop right into leg triangles, right? And that's not the surprise one I told you about, by the way. So try to stay upright. Try to get the right clinch on the thing. Get the footwork. Get the couple taps. Be careful and tap early. All right. Repetition. Live people, here we come. Make sure you're doing it right. All right. So now, welcome back. We're going to put it together. So I'm going to start my open guard position with Mr. Anderson. So I'm here. He's got his feet on me, right? I'm controlling his pat legs, and I'm starting to work on his legs. So he's starting to do whatever, and I'm stepping into my nice little sweet spot position where I'm getting on the inside of his leg, and I'm killing this foot so I can pass, but I see an opportunity, right? I say, hey, I would like to leg lock this thing. So I keep it up super high, and I kind of squat and wrap my arm. Now from here, I'm going to make sure that this leg doesn't come in and push on me and mess with me or wrap around, so I'm tied into that leg. I'm going to fall back. From here, my knees are going to come together. I'm going to cinch my hand up super high, and then I'm going to just tuck my elbows. I'm going to fall not all the way back. So I'm not going to fall all the way back first and then try to pull on the ankle. I'm going to be upright. I can step on his belt, right, or right on his belt, right on his ribs, and I squeeze and I get my tap. Let go. Roll back, hop up, okay? So I'm going to do this a couple times. I'll verbally walk through the steps. If you have it down, go ahead and start getting your repetition from open guard. If you don't, feel free to watch or feel free to do the steps with me. I don't have to be going very fast. And I'm going to slightly rotate angles every single time I do it, and then Mr. Anderson will do the same thing, okay? So we're here, we're controlling the legs. I'm popping up, grabbing, stepping back here, cinch up nice and tight. I step on him. I have my hands up high. I arch. Squeeze my elbows together. Backwards roll up on my feet. I'm going to keep going after the same leg. This way it's not as confusing. You should always try to practice both sides. But if you're used to watching me do one leg, I don't want to mess it up for you. I go here and I go. Now I can do this. I grab my own uniform, right? Now what happens when I go here, he tries to turn his foot out. Same process, but now I have this hand. I can step back. I can look here. The same arching motion. One-handed. So while I'm doing it, I can't use my own because I'm doing gi, right? Because I'm doing a uniform sport. I can grab my own uniform. Grab my hand's gonna just make it a little bit tighter for me. Give me a little bit more muscle across my back because I have both sides flexing instead of one side flexing. But if we're here, right, and I jump up here and I get this, I can push this open, grab my own uniform, have a seat, and attack this leg. And try and get that leg to break. One more time. Last angle, so we're here, right? Get the legs, grab my own uniform or grab my hand, whichever one works better for me. I have a seat, I'm here. Now, when I'm pulling down, I'm pretty loose on his leg, right? Because I'm coming in pretty hot. I don't want to be grabbing a super tight fall because I might apply that. So when I'm dropping down, remember, I am kind of loose. And now at this point, I cinch up high and then I get the submission all from the ground position, okay? We're going to swap jobs, let Mr. Anderson take over. He's going to explain the steps as he does them. Again, following along step by step, just listening in the background or totally ignoring us and just practicing. It's not the one I suggest. She's here.
Grab the hand legs. Push one down. Stay at the same side. Get in close. Wrap around. Grab. Start to drop down. Pull up. Cinch up. Shrug. Make sure you put on the hip. hard, grab pant legs, one down, in, wrap around, grab,
cinch, shrug. Drop down, foot on the hips, ribs, cinch up, and shrug.
Get around, step up, drop down, step up hips.
Nice. All right, one more time. We're gonna come see if you got it.
Hand legs, push one down, get in, grab around, drop down, push, cinch, and shrug.
All right, so again, if you're not live with us, it's your chance to keep getting reps until you think you have it all the way down, and then return and watch the last part of class. Let's say I've got this, oh, keep going the same way, in case you can watch me the whole time. Welcome back, we're going to talk about this toe thing. So when he puts his foot in my armpit, either intentionally, accidentally, or I just get a hold of it, he pulls his toes back and he flexes his foot like a sidekick, right? Which means toes back, heel out, because now it's like a boot. And a lot of people will try to stretch back, but his ankle's pretty strong. So all I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get my same grip up high, I'm gonna cinch my elbows, and I'm gonna wiggle. And just wiggle, that's it, right? So he's gonna pull his toes back, I'm gonna try and do one where I just muscle back, and I can probably straighten out, but he's doing a great job, right? I can hear he tries to keep it flexed, and I just wiggle. I'm just going, right, dance. I'm just dancing my way back. So he pulls back. I do it one way. I'm just trying to lean back. It works for him. He keeps it the same way. I just wiggle. Up, tight. Great. Cool. So let's practice. Put the boot on. It's called put the boot on. It's like you put your foot in a boot, right? So I put my foot in his armpit, and I put my boot on. Yeah, I pull my toes back. And he tries to just cinch up high and lean back. And I say, no, thank you, right? And then he cinches up high, and he wiggles back and forth. Yeah, good. Foot tap. Ready? So he does it again. I put my boot on. He's up super high. He's trying to get it. And the problem is you just don't have leverage, right? He just can't get it from there. But now he just wiggles. He turns his shoulders. And instead of just wiggling up, it's kind of like a rolling motion. Yeah. Yeah. So go ahead and give that a couple tries with your partner. But like I promised earlier, I was going to show one more example of a leg lock. It's kind of fun. Be very careful whenever you play with people's legs. You could hurt their knees. Let's say I have Mr. Anderson here, right, and I'm playing with these legs. We were working on what's called a sweet spot, right? I'm behind the leg, I'm up on this leg, because from this position, if he tries to do a lot of his things, it's pretty easy just to pass the foot and pass into side control, right? So we'll rotate a little bit. So if I'm playing with these feet, right, and what happens, I can take this foot and throw it across. Watch, I step over and I cinch the leg. Now he's stuck. Not just grip here, arch back, and he can't go anywhere. Isn't that awesome? It's pretty cool, right? I told you I'd give you a fun little fact here. But it makes it much harder for him to get out, so I can just control him. Now I gotta be careful, because I could start to hurt his knee. And I don't wanna attack the knee by accident. I never wanna approach a knee attack by accident, because I could hurt his knee. But that's like just a more fancy, fun way to do it. I don't wanna get into that, because I believe you could actually hurt your partner until you're good at that one. But that's kind of the reason why we don't stick our foot on the same side we worked on today, because of the ankle lock. It's illegal a lot of times. Or the heel hook, but it could happen, or someone accidentally does it, or just they don't understand it, they just grab and they just start pulling at things, and there's a risk of injury there, so I like it on the other side, and then kind of showing you how to get out of the boot, and then like I promised, I'll show you something a little bit cooler at the end, and that's kind of just a step over, and I won't get into it very much today, but maybe we'll have more advanced people down the road, so hopefully you like the straight ankle locks. Be very careful, always talk to partners anytime we do a submission, let them know where it's going to hurt, how it's going to hurt, and when it's going to hurt, and make sure they're tapping early. Go super slow. Some people aren't focusing, all of a sudden pop, and then we have injuries and we have less people to beat up on. Cool, thank you for joining me today. We're gonna hop up and bow out.
All right, so attention position, back straight, point your fingers, curl your thumbs, hands on the side of your body, attention position, and a bow. Thank you very much.